डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? यस डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इंडिया एंड द वर्ल्ड, मींस हाउ द इंडिया हैड अ कॉन्टैक्ट विद अदर कंट्रीज एंड विद एशियन कंट्रीज लाइक वेस्टर्न एशियन कंट्रीज एंड ईस्टर्न एशियन कंट्रीज, एंड इंडिया हैज अ स्ट्रेटेजिक लोकेशन. सो Now I am going to continue that topic. Yes. So listen here students, up to here we have studied about only sea routes, how the India had a contact with other countries like we had to go to Western Asian countries to reach Western Asian countries or Europe or Africa. We have to go through Arabian Sea, right, to reach Australia and Eastern Asian countries. We have to go through Bay of Bengal, means sea routes. But listen here students, already you know that Vasco da Gama, he found the sea routes to India when the year of 1498. The Vasco da Gama, he found the sea route to India. But listen here students, before that, means in the previous days also, India had a good contact with other countries. How the people, they were moving from one country to another country, and how they had a good contact, good relationship with other countries. That one we are going to study today. So just you think that apart from sea routes, we have other ways also. There are many types of transportation. Those are waterways, airways, and land transport. So before going to explore or before going to find the sea route to India, they had good transportation system on the land. Land routes. So, land routes are older than India's maritime. So, what do you mean by maritime here? So, already you know that land routes. What do you mean by maritime? See, listen here, friends. Maritime means sea routes. Maritime means sea routes. See, before sea routes, we were transporting from one place to another place by the help of the ways, roads, means by the land only, on the land only. Already you know that in the north side of the India, we can see mountains. It is fully covered by the mountains. We can see various passes. Yes, across the mountains, they have provided, they contributed many passages. Passages means ways in the north. In the north of the India, we can see many passages, many passes across the mountains. They have provided passages, ways. Passages means ways to one country to another country or one place to another place. The ancient people, they were traveling from one place to, from India to other countries or from other country to India. They were using these mountain passages. And these routes have contributed in exchange of ideas and commodities. These land routes, they have yes, contributed to exchange of ideas. Right? What do you mean by commodities? Yes, commodities means, yes, very essential things. Daily we are using important things. Okay, so those are called as commodities. We were exchanging that commodities and some ideas with the other countries. Yes, in the ancient time only, by the help of the land routes. How? For example, now I'll tell about India. Okay. Yes. So from India, yes, from India, other countries, they have taken so many ideas, so many commodities by these routes. What are those? Listen here. Yes. So the ideas of yes, Bhagavad Gita. Yes, ideas of Bhagavad Gita, Ramayana. Yes, stories of Panchatantra. Yes, and listen here, students, very important. And Indian numeral system. One more important is some commodities also. Yes, commodities means so many essential things they have taken from India. For example, spices, and right? Muslin. In the previous class, in the 8th class, you have studied what is muslin. Yes. Muslin is a type of cloth. So these type of ideas they have taken from India by the help of the land routes. Okay. In the next class, I will tell and I will explain about what type of ideas and what type of commodities we have taken from other countries. Okay. So in the next class, we will discuss about that. Until that, take care. Bye-bye.